G'day boys and girls, it's Colin back again for Sunday School. Today we're going to meet Alec. I've known Alec for a long time, and Alec is going to talk about his mother. His mother is 104 years old, and Alec is in his early 80s. Really nice to meet both of them. Unfortunately, his mother's lost her hearing quite a lot, so Alec's going to share about his mother and about his childhood, his upbringing, and very, very challenging listening to it. Alec brought up a little home without electricity, without running water, and without even having the things we take for granted, like a toilet. And I've been traveling with Alec to Poland, to India, and a wonderful man of God. He loves the book, he loves the Bible, and he loves to mark it. Never be afraid to mark your Bible. And of course, he's got a great memory for poetry, for scripture, etc. But before we meet Alec, we're going to sing a song, and then we'll look at a couple of Bible verses which were Alec's favourites. Stop, and let me tell you. Song Stop and Let Me Tell You. Alec was sharing with us, he's going to read to us John 3 verse 16 17. Lots of people know verse 16, but you know verse 15, the previous and the one after verse 17. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. And we were just sharing when Alec was a wee boy, his mother was a little girl, how the Bible was God's word, God's book, and it hasn't changed. And the clothes that Alec's wearing, he didn't wear them when he was a wee boy. He's quite a trendy young man now. And yet the Bible, God's word, does not change at all. John 3, 16, 17, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the, but that the world through him might be saved. And that message is still equally important today as it ever was, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. So boys and girls, that's a lovely Bible verse, John 3, 16, 17. Let's pray. Father, we just thank you for your word. We'll thank you for these beautiful verses in John's gospel. Right throughout the Bible, every word of God is so precious and so real and so true, because it's your word, it's God's word. Bless Sunday School today, and bless Alec and his mother as we go to visit them. In Christ's lovely name we pray. Amen. Jesus loves the little children, and I'm sure when Alec was a wee boy, he was no innocent little child. She even told me, she had a silly run, yes, for Alec, for making him the man he is today. Jesus loves the little children.
Jesus loves the little children of the world. black and white, they are precious in the sight. Jesus loves the little children of the world.
Brilliant song, really, really enjoyed. Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world. So let's meet Alec and meet Alec's mother, Martha, as well.
G'day, boys and girls. Today we're with Alec, Alec Wallace. Alec, say hello to the children.
Hello, children.
Alec, you were once a wee boy.
Yes.
Can you remember when you were a child?
I do indeed.
And we're going to meet Alec's mother today. Alec's mother. Alec, can we ask how old you are?
82.
Well, and how old's your mother?
104.
104 years old?
Yeah.
Is she the oldest person in Northern Ireland?
I don't think so, no.
She must be getting close.
She would be.
What's the secret of her old age, Alec?
Hard work.
Oh, was she a hard worker?
Aye.
Alec, if I asked her, she would tell me the truth, but I'm going to ask you, when you were a wee boy, were you a good child?
I got beat like every other child in them times.
What was a good spanking, Alec? Because nowadays, boys and girls, that doesn't happen today. Your folks would go to prison. But then there's, I got slapped too, but what was a good spank?
A good spank with a sally rod along the back of the legs.
A sally, what's a sally rod?
A stick out of the hedge.
Yeah. I remember that too. And when Alec, when you were spanked, did you learn the lesson?
For a short time.
You were spanked regular?
Yeah.
You know that voice?
I know Alec.
Hi, Alec, my son.
He's some boy. Was he a good child when he was small?
Yes.
He was?
And I used to tell the other sons, Wayne, when they come to stay with me, if you're a bad boy, I'll put you across my knee and smack your butt. When they come to see me, there's the sally rod.
The sally rod, he mentioned that.
Yeah. It's funny how they all remember.
You haven't forgot? No.
I'm 104. I was 104 on the 8th of August.
Wow.
I had a hard working life.
Yeah.
And they say hard work never killed anybody.
Never. It never killed you. It never killed you.
But I have been stuck in a drainage.
Oh, you have?
Even here.
Alec, what was childhood like back in the early 1900s?
Well, it was completely different. I remember the sewer coming into the village. I remember the electric light coming into the village. I remember the water coming into the village.
So before that you didn't have?
No, there was nothing in the village. And people worked in the mosses to cut peat, and that was the way they heated the houses.
So, Alec, before water came into your house, how did you get water?
The water got from the water pump up on the street.
Was there a toilet, Alec?
A dry toilet.
As opposed to a wet toilet?
A dry toilet was an outside house where a bucket was used.
So, Alec, electricity, you know, light switch?
No, there's no lights. There was tilly lamps and oil lamps.
Many years ago was that, Alec?
I was born in 42. I was probably 10 or 11 when all this started happening.
So, boys and girls, this is Alec, very much alive, and when he's a child at primary school, no electricity in his home, no running water, and no lights, running water, or did you have no hot shower, Alec? No bath?
Oh no, there's a tin bath, and you get bathed once a week on a Saturday night.
How did you fill that up with buckets?
Well, it was filled. The water was boiled, and it was filled, and everybody got bathed, and the one bath.
One after another.
One after the other.
How many siblings did you have?
There were seven. Of us all together.
Were you the oldest?
I was the oldest fella. Do
you get into a clean water, Alec? There were seven of us too,
yeah.
And Saturday night was bath night.
Uh-huh.
And so you want to go to the toilet in the middle of the night, either wet to bed or you went outside?
You went outside.
You went outside? So times have changed, Alec.
Yes.
Young ones, children couldn't imagine that now.
No, they laugh at you when they're telling you and tell them them stories.
Alec, did you enjoy school?
I was good, aye.
What age did you become a Christian at?
I was 16.
And is the Bible an important book to you, Alec?
That's very important.
Why is that?
Well, it's the Word of God, and the Word of God never changes.
Mm-hmm. So even when you were a wee boy at 6 or 16, that's the same book that you're reading today?
Yeah.
Why does it not need to update it and change, Alec?
It doesn't need to update it and change because...
But the house has changed, the water, the electricity, the clothes.
But God's word never changes, the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Look, you're a very modern looking man, Alec. When you were 16, you didn't dress like that.
No.
You're the most dressed man in Randallstown. And Alec, you travel, don't you, on mission trips?
I did, yeah.
Where have you been to?
I've been to Kenya a few times. I've been to Ethiopia. I've been to India. I've been to Lithuania.
You've been to Poland?
Poland, quite a number of times, probably about 12 times.
So even Alec, at your age, once somebody retires, they can still serve God by travelling at home or abroad.
Yes.
And Alec, can you serve God without being within church, outside church? Can you serve God?
Well, you can serve God in church and outside church.
People still need reached?
Oh,
yeah. Mm,
yeah.
Oh, what do you enjoy about the Christian life, Alec?
Well, I enjoy meeting people and enjoy talking to people.
Do you find it hard to talk about the Lord?
Not really, no. No. Mm-hmm. No.
And the people say to you, Alec, why do you read that book? Do you have to read that book, the Bible?
Well, it's important to read the Word of God and to pray. It's both important.
Does God speak to you as you read, Alec?
Oh, He speaks to you through His Word, yeah.
So whether you're a child or an adult or a grandfather, you're still equally read the Word of God?
Yeah.
Mm. And Alec, how often do you visit your mum?
Probably three times a week. Three times.
That's important, Alec, not to forget about your mother.
That is important, yes.
Yeah. And are you enjoying your retirement, Alec?
Yes, I have. I've had good long retirement.
The Lord's good to you?
Yeah.
Yeah. And if it was a child watching saying, I'd love to be able to read the Bible, where would you encourage them to start reading?
Reading John's Gospels. The Gospels of John is a very...
Have you a favourite Bible verse, Alec?
Well, I've several favourite Bible verses. John 3:16 is one of them. And
can you say it?
For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. The next verse, for this is life eternal, that we might know Thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ whom Thou hast sent.
And Alec, is it true you're a poet and nobody really knows it?
A poet?
Yeah.
Well, I like poetry.
Where does that come from, Alec, a love for poetry? But you also write. Do you write or just because it's all done your head?
Well, I write some bits of poetry.
Do you want to tell us one?
Well, I won just offhand.
You will before I finish the day. You always do. You're very good. Alec, you make a good cup of tea.
Good.
Oh, hi, you're a good man. And Alec, over the years, do you find the country's in decline or an increase as far as spiritual values are concerned?
Probably on the decline at the moment, you know.
Mm-hmm. What's revival, Alec, to you?
Revival is a drawn out after the Saviour, a risen Saviour, drawn out after Him.
Mm-hmm.
The Scripture says that we may know Him and the power of His resurrection.
Mm-hmm. It's getting to know Him.
Aye.
And the more you know Him, the more you want to please Him and be like Him. Mm-hmm. Do you have a favourite book in the Bible, Alec?
John's Gospels.
Oh, you like reading the John's Gospel, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
The life of Christ?
Yeah, it's an opening up to the life of Christ.
Do you look forward to meeting the Lord one day, Alec?
I do.
Mm-hmm. Do you think you get the well done of God?
I don't deserve it.
No, you don't, but you will, Alec. Yeah, I know you will, yeah. I've known Alec a long time, boys and girls, on trips in India and Poland, and he's one of the people I know who loves the Word of God more than anyone and reads it. And once he gets going, he's like a diesel engine. He just doesn't stop. He really loves the Word, and he's a real gift at poetry. But his wee mind's working overtime, and within a wee minute, he's going to give us a poem. But, Alec, you try to read the Bible every day.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That's good. Because sometimes technology and phones almost replace people's energy and time. Why a paper Bible, Alec, rather than a phone Bible?
Well, I think that it's important to have the Word there and all the Word rather than looking it up. You have it all in your hand.
Yeah. Do you ever mark your Bible, Alec?
Oh, I
would. Nothing wrong with doing that?
No.
Mm-hmm.
I have an older Bible that's all marked.
All marked, yeah. Mm-hmm. And then would you replace your Bible every now and again?
Well, I actually bought that Bible there in Kenya.
And you bought an English Bible in Africa?
Aye. And if you look on the pages, you'll get all the different ministers there.
Yeah, yeah.
And missionaries. And someone said to me, why do you have their names? Why do you bother having their names?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I said, if you open your scripture, the names is there, and then you can pray for them.
Wow, it's a little name.
I think your name's there, Colin.
Is it there?
Aye.
I would hardly be worthy to have my name in your Bible, Alec. Did I present you with that Bible? Alec, would you like to read a wee portion of what you like reading?
Romans chapter 10. Reading from verse number 6. But the righteousness which is of faith speaketh on this wise, say not in thine heart, who shall descend into heaven, that is to bring Christ down from above, or who shall descend into the deep, that is to bring up Christ again from the dead. But what saith it? The word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart. That is the word of faith which we preach, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. For the scripture saith, whosoever believeth on him shall not be ashamed.
All right, very good. And the next one, Alex 13, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. My favourite verse.
Mm.
Wonderful. Have you got a poem yet, Alec?
Well, this poem...
Told you it's coming.
This is not my poem, but this is a poem by Charles Rolls, who was one of the Rolls-Royce families, and he wrote several books, and his books are very poetic. And this particular poem is three small verses, but it's called... O Christ divine, O Christ divine, thine is the greatest fame that truth's fair records have declared of old. The witness of thy deeds and glorious name soars higher as the mounting years unfold. O Christ divine, thine is the greatest power that sways a scepter or displays a crown, controlling ages and this present hour, increasing daily in thy famed renown. O Christ divine, thine is the greatest might. No majesty nor strength compares with thine to banish darkness and establish light, the light of truth which evermore shall shine.
Wow. No notes. I told you it was coming. And Alec could rhyme off probably dozens, if not hundreds, of poems. Not just old poems, modern poems, but poems he sometimes writes himself. Alec, what's the gift of memorization?
Repetition. Same as you learn when you're at school, your tables repeating and repeating only.
Repetition.
And that's how you learn, as by repetition.
Scripture verses as well.
That's how you learn it, by repetition.
There's no easier way, Ali.
You learn the line, you learn two lines, you learn the verse, then you go to the second verse, and you could go as many verses as long as you keep at it.
But Alex, it's true, the younger you are, the easier it is to memorise.
Have you any trouble?
Did he hear what he said? If I, Alec, did he? That's Alec just getting warmed up. But I mean, Alec, primary school children can recite and learn things really quickly.
Aye.
Like learning a language, the younger you are, the easier it is.
Aye, it would be easier the younger you are. Mm.
Children often ask me, how do I know so many Bible verses or Bible stories? Mm. I learned them as a child.
Mm.
But Alec still rhymes them off. It's wonderful. Alec, thanks very much for taking the time to meet your mother. Your mother, no doubt, had a hard life, Alec, weren't you?
Well, she had a big family to her, and it wasn't easy.
Yeah, but she's in a home now, taking good care of now.
That's right.
Alec, whenever you go to visit the home, do they think you've escaped? They try to put you to bed?
Well, there is younger people than me in the home.
There is?
There is, aye.
That's powerful. Mm.
And there's some as young as you.
He's an awful man, that's twice.
There is. I'm not joking. Right.
So if I go up to visit Alec, they're going to put me to bed.
Oh, the people younger than you there.
Younger, that's powerful. Boys and girls, thanks for watching. Alec, say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye bye now.
Really enjoyed meeting Alec and meeting Alec's mother, who's now in a home at 104 years old. A real challenge for children to look just like their mother brought you into the world and looked after you. It all comes a time and the whole thing's turned around, and as children, you've got to look after your parents, your mother, your father as well. Let's sing, finish off with Deep and Wide. Do the action. Wonderful song. Let's pray. Father, thank you for Sunday school today. Thank you for the children watching and families. And we'll thank you for Alec, for his dedication, for his love for the Lord Jesus, his love for his family, his love for his country, and his love for his mother. And we just pray you'll bless Alec in these days and his mother's too, as he looks after her and visits her and reads a wonderful word of God. And we pray, Lord, you'll just encourage him, and may he be a great inspiration and encourage to many people as he meets along life's way. In Jesus' lovely name we pray. Amen. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.